Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Cory Heitz.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is a quick mini episode today, and we're going to talk about a topic of timing for the prep school world. To start, first, if you like this podcast, feel free to subscribe on any of the major podcasting platforms, and you can also subscribe to YouTube. We've also got bonus content, and you guys can make sure you don't miss a thing. I'm not asking for reviews or comments, but if you like what you hear, make sure to share some episodes with some friends. And this is trying to get as much good information as possible. So if you decide to go to prep school, you can either reach out to me or you can make your own decision based on the information you have now. And to me, information and options equal power. So the more you know, the better it is. Okay, we're going to talk about timing. So you have two options if you're looking at prep schools. And we're going to, just for this first example, talk about a post-grad year. So if you're looking to do a post-grad year after your senior year of high school, It's broken down into two types of camps, right? The first camp is the family that knows at the beginning of the school year that, hey, we're going to do our senior year here, but then the following year, we're going to do a post-grad year. And they know this going into their senior year. So they might reach out to me in August or September or to a prep school coach, find out who's interested, find out, talk to coaches and learn more about their program, set up visits, get in application packages, and have plenty of time to do all of this before their own high school basketball season starts. So it's a much more relaxed way of doing things. Prep schools have all of their financial aid available before they send out acceptance letters, and the roster spots for next year's team have not been filled yet. So it's a really good time. It's relaxed. It's not rushed, and it's got its benefits with that. The only problem with that is if you're at a school that does not give its decision until March 10th, you might start talking to a coach in September and not find out if you've gotten into that school or not until March 10th. And then if you get in, you will then find out what your financial aid package will be as well, right? So a lot of that depends, on a bunch of factors which are in other podcasts. But that's the timing of starting early, okay? If you start later, right? Say you play your high school season, didn't even think about post-grad, but you didn't get any offers you wanted. After season in February or March, you might start looking around trying to figure out, all right, should I do a post-grad year next year? There's advantages to this as well. The advantages are, after April 10th, once a lot of these prep schools know if they have all their roster spots filled or if they've got financial aid, we can make deals quick. So you can call up a coach real quick and say, I'm a guard. I've got $30,000. Do you have a spot for me? And that coach is going to say, yes, we have a spot. That money works. Or, we filled our roster. We're not looking anymore. So real quick where coaches stand and what kind of money situations work. In the past, I've had kids and families who could have paid $65,000, but since they reached out to prep schools in May and June when they needed a couple beds to fill and maybe one roster spot still available, these families that could have paid $65,000 might end up paying $25,000 or $30,000, right? So there are deals to be made. It's very intricate. You got to know what schools do that. But there are advantages of waiting till later to where maybe if that same family applied before the deadline, they might have got a letter on March 10th saying you have to pay full tuition. So there are advantages both ways. You have more options if you start early, but later there might be less options, but you can move quicker. Now, we're talking about schools now that have application deadlines and the acceptance letters go out March 10th. There are also schools out there that have rolling admissions. Schools like that include South Kent, Bridgeton Academy, Winchendon, just to name a few, right? And those schools, you can talk to them in September. If you visit, apply, like it, you can commit and you're done until you show up next August on campus. So there are advantages to knowing which schools have rolling admissions and you can commit right away before your senior year even starts. So that's a little bit about how the timing of the prep school works. A lot of families ask me, are we doing this too early? Some families ask me, are we too late? And it just depends on each situation. There's no right or wrong. It's going to work out. There's going to be options for you. It's just the aid might be different. The availability of schools might be different. But know this too. Even up until the first day of school in August, there are still schools calling last minute saying, we have a spot, a kid just left and signed with college, or a kid just left because his parents moved to Europe or something like that. there are moves that can happen up until August. Okay, so do not be dismayed. There's really no time to do it. There are even programs that will take kids during the school year as well. And if you need information on these schools, you know, feel free to reach out to them and ask them, or reach out to me. I can help as well. So that's today's episode. It's a short one, but it's about timing in the prep school world and when to reach out. Real quick, if you're an underclassman, right, it's always good to start sooner than later. But once again, you can also do it during the summer. It also depends on roster spots, needs, financial aids, but it can absolutely be done if you're not a post-grad either. So this is Cory Heitz. This is the Prep Athletics Podcast. Thank you for tuning in. If you got any questions, you can find me at prepathletics.com. My email is coryheitz@gmail.com. And I'm on Twitter more than anything else. And yeah, subscribe. And any feedback or questions, would love to hear them. Thanks so much. Have a good day.